Hey there, wealth builders. Welcome back to Wealth Builders Wisdom, where we unlock the secrets of financial success, one video at a time. Today, we're sailing into uncharted waters with a topic that's stirring up the world of finance: central bank digital currencies, or CBDCs.
The central bank. Nearly every country in the world has a central bank, or institution that manages the currency and monetary policy of an entire country. Unlike a commercial bank, a central bank has a monopoly on how much money can be created and put in circulation. That's quite a power, as historically, countries have risen and fallen due to the value of their currency. Because of the powerful nature of central banks, most countries have made theirs institutionally independent from political interference, meaning that governments can't use them to control society. So, why do we let these central banks have so much power? The simple answer is to prevent economic crashes and keep markets stable, based on all the devastating recessions throughout history that occurred when we didn't have central banks. Let's look at an example.
Are they the next big wave in our economic ocean, or just a ripple in the financial pool? Let's dive in and find out.
Central banks around the world are examining whether they should create digital currencies. China is gradually enrolling one already. Japan may launch a digital yen by 2026. India is moving ahead in this front. The Federal Reserve is on the bandwagon here, where experiments and studies are already underway. These moves to what is dubbed a central bank digital currency, CBDC, may sound like making sure financial institutions are keeping up to date and ensuring currency stability amid cryptos that are crashing in value, along with the sensational multi-billion dollar collapse of crypto exchange FTX.
What exactly are CBDCs? Imagine your regular currency, but in digital form, issued and regulated by a country's central bank. This isn't Bitcoin or Ethereum we're talking about. It's a whole new ballgame. Central banks worldwide are exploring this concept, and it's not hard to see why. In a world where digital transactions are king, CBDCs promise efficiency, security, and a potential revolution in monetary policy. Now, you might be wondering, how do CBDCs differ from the digital money we use every day? Well, the key lies in their foundation. Unlike the digital dollars in your bank account, which are representations of physical money, CBDCs are the real deal, digital currency with the full backing of their issuing government. This distinction could mean a world of difference in how we handle money in the future. So, what's driving this digital currency craze? It's all about adapting to the digital age. CBDCs could make transactions faster, more transparent, and maybe even cheaper. But, as with anything new, there are concerns. What about privacy? Security? The impact on traditional banking? And hey, if you're finding this journey into the future of finance as fascinating as I am, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Join our Wealth Builders community and never miss out on our insightful videos. Let's talk global impact. Some countries are already testing the waters. Take China, for instance, piloting its digital yuan. The implications are huge, from how we buy our morning coffee to how governments implement monetary policy. But it's not just about making payments easier. CBDCs could give governments new tools for economic control and financial monitoring. This could mean a seismic shift in the balance of economic power. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. The road to a world dominated by digital currencies is long and filled with technical, ethical, and financial potholes.
Whether what we're seeing is the argument, a proof of concept perhaps, of central banks needing to lead the way in payment systems. Kristalina, I'll begin with you.
When somebody promises you 20% return on something that is not backed by any assets, how would we normally call this thing?
Starting about the fact that you mentioned, Julia, that currency is about trust for centuries, and it's about technological innovations for centuries also. Remember of the banknotes. No, none of us was alive 2 or 3 centuries ago, but it was a tremendous technological progress for central bank currency at that time. And in order to have the best of trust, which comes more from central bankers and the public side, and technological innovation, which comes more from the private sector, there is a partnership. And for decades, there has been a partnership in issuing money and in organizing the payment system. So one word about crypto and one word about CBDC on this partnership. Crypto, I always speak of crypto assets and not cryptocurrencies, and not by chance, because as Kristalina just said, they are not a reliable currency. They are not a reliable mean of payment. In order to be a currency, somebody must be responsible for the value. Nobody is responsible for the value of cryptos.
It's, you know, what is, what do we try to fix? What do we try to address? And when you go back and you said it roughly some 10 years ago or 8 years ago here at the WEF, this was blockchain and that will revolutionize and banks are gone and everything will be completely different. We are still here, fortunately, so glad that I can sit here on that chair.
Governments were
so you had then,
I
obviously, as Kristalina clearly said, you know, cryptocurrencies, crypto assets, that's one thing. Then the stable or not so stable coins in the middle. And now we talk about central bank digital currencies. So central banks strongly feel, at least in certain jurisdictions, there's a certain need that needs to be addressed.
So, wealth builders, are CBDCs the next big wave in our financial future, or just a temporary blip on the radar? The jury's still out, but one thing's for sure. The world of finance is on the cusp of a digital revolution, and we'll be here to guide you through it every step of the way.
Hold our analysis on CBDC in particular for the use of general, to the general use. We tend to establish the equivalence with cash, and there is a huge difference there. For example, in cash, we don't know, for example, who's using a $100 bill today. We don't know who is using a 1,000 peso bill today. A key difference in with the CBDC is that central bank will have absolute control on the rules and regulations that will determine the use of that expression of central bank liability. And also, we will have the technology to enforce that. Those two issues are extremely important, and that makes a huge difference with respect to what cash is.
Before you go, if you've enjoyed our deep dive into the digital currency ocean, give us a like and subscribe for more financial wisdom. Stay ahead of the curve with Wealth Builder's Wisdom. Until next time, keep building your wealth, and keep building your wisdom.